I am buzzing. This is like, it's like an Apple product launch. I've got so much adrenaline, I've just been sick in the bugs. Oh. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Such an honour to be here on TFI Friday, the final episode. I love this show. I love pretending it's still the 1990s. Of course, it's Chris Evans we have to thank for bringing this great show back. He told me he hates people who take old ideas and revamp them. So, instead, he took an old idea and just rehashed it. That's great. But we have a humdinger of a show for you, and it's going to be just as irrelevant and feral as always, as punk rock, as Def Leppard, Whitesnake or Toya. I'm well up for this. Mad for it, as they used to say in the 90s. Not literally. Channel 4 insists on a full mental health check to satisfy their insurers. But I'm raring to go and I'm in great shape. Had a bit of trouble with a prominent underarm cyst, but it was benign. I got it drained and flattened, and here I am. Tonight, my guests include Lee Mack and Sir Tom Jones, whilst... and Jack Whitehall and James Corden. Jack Whitehall and James Corden will be competing to see who can look the most pleased with themselves. But now a man who, despite being well over 40, puts two fingers up to middle-aged guys wearing T-shirts and sneakers by doing it himself. Let's face it, with that red hair dye, there's no stopping him. It's a branding thing. Please welcome Chris Evans! Shirt with a very humorous turkey sticking out of your stomach. That's what happens at Christmas, isn't it? A turkey literally sticks half out of your stomach.
Anyway,
thank you. Do you like what I'm...
I love what you're wearing. Thank you. You look fantastic.
Thank you. Well, I had this bomber jacket embroidered with the image of baby Jesus. There you can see in the back. can we see that again in slow motion?
I think we can, yeah. I think we can.
Brilliant.
Excellent, yeah. No, it's hand-stitched. It was hand-stitched in China by precisely the kind of children King Herod spent Christmas trying to slaughter. My way of telling the guy to swivel. OK. It's time now for our first performance of the night. Chris, if you don't mind, you just sit there. I'll take care of everything. It's the first performance of the night from a legendary Welsh Knight of the Realm. He has the voice of an angel. An angel with balls of steel, meaning he probably couldn't fly very well. He just clanks along at the bottom of heaven like a coin in a washing machine. Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Tom Jones.
Take my love. Need you when the day is through. Why don't you take
superstar guest host Alan Partridge with us this evening. We need some superstar guest barman. How about, for the first time on live TV in ages, Zig and Zag are here! Yeah! Boys, boys, boys! Zaggity bow!
Chrissity schmeow!
Ziggity doo!
Hi, Dad!
Hi!
Dad. Hi, son! Uncle Chris!
No, I know.
Sorry,
you said
Dad.
You'd never say that. You said you'd never say that. You
yeah,
see
sorry, sorry.
Okay. How are you, Chris?
It's been a long time, hasn't it?
Yes, yeah, it's been
a
very ages.
Long time. You look amazing.
Thanks.
You haven't changed at all. You haven't aged at all.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah. Zig, can you still do the thing? The
Oh, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Careful now. He's a little older.
Yay! Yeah!
You gotta love that. You have to love that, don't you?
Still got it.
Okay, so I could actually do a proper interview with you because you have a new project, don't you, Zig and Zag?
Yes, indeed. We have an animation series on the CBBC coming next year.
Nice. Yeah. That's very impressive. What are you looking forward to most about that?
What?
What?
The animation series.
Well, you know what's brilliant, Christopher?
What?
They draw you.
Yes.
You're not real anymore. You're drawn.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And they give you legs.
You got legs?
Yes!
Whoa!
We got legs!
Wait a minute. You mean I don't have legs?
No. Oh! Zig, you've never had legs. It's okay, you've
Zig,
never had legs.
Come on. Zig, come on.
You've never had legs, it's been fine so far. You can have like socks and tights and
What is it, Zig? Yeah, don't think about it too
much. Don't think about it, otherwise you will fall down again.
Okay, yeah. No.
You can have shoes, you can have trainers just, for Christmas.
Oh yeah, hang on.
What?
We're not gonna need these anymore because we don't know what they are.
Okay. Have those. Thank you. Yeah. Right, so you're going to make some cocktails for our guest this evening.
Yeah, yes, that's what we're here for. We're born it.
But we need a guest. Alan!
Hello!
And
thanks, Chris. Now do James Corden intro. Sorry, I'm not supposed to read that bit. Time now for our first guest. He's the perfect fit for a show as anarchic and anti-establishment as TFI and has recently been awarded an OBE from Her Majesty the Queen. Doesn't say what for. Please welcome, with his Order of the British Empire, which I think now is basically Northern Ireland and the Falklands. Please welcome James Corden, OBE.
How are you doing?
Zig and Zag!
You're so real!
You're so are you!
Hi, James! Now, James, we're the barman this evening and we've created bespoke cocktails.
Yeah.
Okay.
Special. Yeah.
See this here?
Yeah. This one?
This
yeah.
is no ordinary cocktail, my
this
friend.
This one?
This is. Tell him, Zig.
The Pina Cordina.
Oh! I see what you've done there.
Yeah.
There it is.
Yeah. And
this is for me?
It's for real, yeah, it's for real, too.
Okay, here we go.
There's extra pina in there.
He loves it!
He loves it!
Yeah! Well done!
Snowballs for questions,
Yes,
indeed, snowballs.
The more bottles you smash for £1, 3 snowballs, the more questions you get asked. Okay, all right, where do I stand? Where do I go? Back.
James, back it! Forward, to me! To me!
Ready? Okay.
Let go!
No!
Smash it!
Okay. Sorry, I wasn't watching. How many bottles did you smash? I got all three.
You got all three?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah. In that case, you get a full interview.
Oh, yay! I'm so happy to be here.
I know.
It's a dream of mine since a child. And I've been watching it in America. I love it so much. I'm so happy to be here. Truly, I am. It's a huge thing for me.
And you just got off a plane, didn't you?
I landed 4:15 just now.
Went home,
yes.
Got a change, came back.
That's it, yes.
Thank you very much indeed.
It's
okay,
a pleasure.
So you're taking over TV in America, we know that. But you have not orphaned A League of Their Own, have you?
No.
You love that program.
Oh, well, I would never stop doing it.
It's never ever?
No, it's the only time.
That's a terrible negotiating stance.
Let's be clear, I'm lying when I say that.
Okay, okay.
No, I love it. It's the only time I don't feel like I'm at work.
Perfect.
And you get to sit with, you meet great people, you have great people there, Jack and Freddie and Jamie, and it's a lovely thing to do 8 times a year. I love it.
Okay, yeah. And it's back in January, and you go rowing. Here is James rowing in the next league of their own.
Here we go. No. Here we go, guys.
Right, you hold these.
I've got him. I'm all over this.
I thought it would be easier than it was. The guy said to me, it's all about weight distribution. I said, who do you think you're talking to? Do I look like someone who's distributed weight evenly in my life?
Push.
Swim.
Was it?
We went to go rowing and just all had a swim.
Nice day.
That's
though.
What happened. It was a great day.
Okay, yeah. So you have taken over late night television. For people who don't know, what do you do in America for a living nowadays?
I host a TV show every day called The Late Late Show, which goes out every night on CBS. It's an hour of TV every night. It's a talk show / variety show.
And it's fair to say it's a smash hit, isn't it? It's fair to say that.
It's doing very well.
It's doing very, very well. Yeah.
It's a big relief.
I understand you almost. In fact, you did say no first of all when you got offered the job.
Yeah. Right? No. Yeah. I just never thought it would be something that I'd do. So I said no a little bit, and then thought, what am I doing? This is crazy. I would rather regret doing something than not doing something.
Absolutely.
So why not just go for it? And if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But at least I won't sit going, oh, I maybe should have had a crack at that, you know.
It's gone spectacularly well, and you know when things go well in America, they literally, because the contracts are very biased with the broadcaster.
Yes.
And so do you have to work there for the rest of your life now?
No, I don't.
How does it
I
work?
Mean, it feels like it sometimes. No, I have to work there for about the next sort of 4.5 years.
Really? Okay. Well, but it's good fun.
I mean, it is a joy. I love doing it so much.
All right, Carpool Karaoke is one of the things he does. This is massive online as well as on his show. Look what goes on here.
Guys, if we're gonna make this work, you've gotta watch me. Liam, concentrate.
Yeah. Liam, it's one note.
Here we go.
Sorry, I was just doing it quiet.
And you love singing.
If I sing a little too much,
and
on
you're on Kylie's new album doing a proper duet, and it's really good.
Thank you very much. It's so stupid. I don't quite know why, but I'm enjoying. Yes, it's
well,
silly.
Good for you, James.
Thank you very much.
All right, we've got a tougher question now. Let's bring on this week's killer question. Here comes my son Noah.
Woo! Okay. Hi, Noah.
Hi.
Hey.
Congratulations on being so brilliant in America.
Thank you, Noah.
And my question is, I've never seen my mum and dad have a row. Have you? And you can't say no.
Well, I've seen my own mum and dad have many, many rows,
yep.
But I've also seen your mum and dad having a colossal row. Was it like two? It was two Christmases ago.
It was Christmas Day.
I think it might have been Christmas Day. And I was at a hotel where we were spending Christmas with my family. And me and my dad had borrowed Segways, right? And we were cruising around Segways. And I'm driving up and I see two people in a car just doing this.
No, I don't.
And I'm like, oh, and I've got like a bobble hat similar to yours on. And I'm like, oh, they're having a, that's Chris Evans. And at that moment, I think I should probably avert my eyes so he doesn't see me. And Chris is going, you do. And then your mum put the window down and they both gave me the politest we're not rowing smiles I've ever seen, where they went, hey, happy Christmas. And then Chris clearly felt like I couldn't. He went, we're having a huge row. And I said, why? And your mum said, because he wants to spend another day in the pub.
This man is a terrible man. He's chosen America over his own country. It's ridiculous.
I've forgotten all about that. That's so funny. Your face. They literally did this. Hey. Oh. We're having a great Christmas. It's wonderful.
I know. James actually said, you've been having a row, haven't you? Right, do you have a card for James? Of course you do.
Yes.
Okay, here's your card.
Oh, thank you so much.
In this card is your first karaoke song of the night. Bring some karaoke, everyone. Okay. Okay.
Well, I mean, it's that time of year. It's White Christmas. Oh,
White Christmas, everyone. Here we go.
And I'm going to... OK, all right. On here?
Oh,
like,
yeah, on the front, that's fine.
I'll stay here for this one. Oh. Here we go. Do you know this song now?
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, when the treetops glisten and children listen.
Celestial choir. Who doesn't like a celestial choir, but only in very small doses? I said to one of the researchers, we should try and get a nativity play going, but they said, you'll never find a virgin in here. I said, still less three wise men. We'd be better off casting everyone here as cattle, because that's what everyone's like here, cattle. Cattle. It's weird when you say the word over and over, isn't it? Cattle. 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 Back to you, Chris.
Thank you. Alan Partridge.
Alan Partridge.
James Corden. James, it's time for It's Your Christmas Letters, OK?
Yes.
OK, Bryan Adams, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
Off you go. If you can see where you're going, keep going, keep going. Mush, 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 mush. Right, letter, please, James. Off you go.
Okay. This letter says, Dear Chris, every Christmas my family play the same old boring party games.
Yep.
How can I make them more exciting?
Well, first of all, you need a TV show. Okay, you need a TV show, a bit of a budget.
Yep.
Okay, then you need a world-class gymnast. Bryony Page will do, if she's around. And then you can play subliminal charades. Bryony, get bouncing! Okay, here we go. When you're ready, James. When you're ready. So it's a film, it's a film. It's a film.
It's a film?
Yep. Two words, two words.
Chicken.
Chicken is the first word, yes.
Chicken run. Chicken run.
Chicken run.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
You've got to go to of those.
Oh, well,
that would work
it.
Really well on American television.
Yeah.
Yeah, seriously. You can have it.
I've been stealing all of it.
I know.
I'm here.
Excuse me. Alan.
Thanks, Chris. Now performing Unstoppable from her album Blood. Ooh. It's Leanne LaHavis.
Christmas complaints.
Yeah.
Yes, we have. People are watching this show live. They're saying your slot is called It's Your Christmas Letters. There was only one letter. James, do we have another one? Exactly.
Dear Chris.
Yes.
Your little boy Noah has been the star of this series.
I agree with that.
Any chance of seeing a little bit of your even littler boy, Eli?
Eli.
Yes.
Wow. We could get Eli on to do his famous up and down eyebrow Christmas party trick.
I thought he said he doesn't want to do it again on TV.
I think we can persuade
because
him.
Because it's the Christmas special.
Should do it for you, I think. His I'd name's love to Eli. See it. Would you like to see Eli Brows?
Yes!
Come on, Eli! Come on! Come on, come on. He wants to come on with his mummy. This, by the way, look at mummy here. Yeah. Come on.
Very different relationship right now, though.
Yeah, come on. Oh, mummy's on. All right. Come on. No, come on, mummy. Mummy, come on, mummy. Hey, mummy. Yeah. Come and sit here, mummy. Sit in the main chair, mummy. Yeah. Anyway, you sit there. Babe, can you cue his eyebrows for me? Thanks. That'd be great. Well, a drum roll, please. Eyebrows, Eli, to that camera.
Eli Brows!
You can have that for America.
Done. Okay, banks it. Deal. Don't you worry. Eli, what are you doing on January 5th?
Have you got another card for James? Another karaoke song, everyone? Yeah?
Oh. Okay.
Okay, here we go. Here we go. What's this one going to be?
Oh, it's only what I consider the best Christmas song of all time.
All right.
Can you help me with it? Yeah. Okay. Are we ready?
Yes.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of
sight. Keep going, James, keep going, it's fine.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Through the years we all will be together if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest.
Crabbies, sponsors of TFI Friday.
Just for Christmas, our master chocolatiers have lovingly created with our finest Lindt chocolate three heartwarming festive figures, like our adorable chocolate teddy with his unique and magical heart charm, full of love and warmth. Perfect for showing you care. Bring the magic home this Christmas with Lindt.
Join me, Alan Carr, straight off the Gogglebox at 10 on Channel 4. Queen of Comedy Tina Fey is in the house. Kevin Bridges will be dropping by. There's music from Lion Babe. And I'll be joined by some of the stars of the new Star Wars movie. Don't you dare miss it.
Crabbies, sponsors of TFI Friday.
Okay, only seven sleeps to go till Christmas, and here is one of them now. Alan.
Thanks, Chris. We've got a drawer here when you open it. It's got a throttle, and it blows snow. What a colossal waste of money. Before I introduce Jack Whitehall. Yeah, he's on next. A piece of trivia. Jack's godfather is the celebrated actor Sir Nigel Havers. Yes. And another piece of trivia. Nigel Havers' father was Sir Michael Havers, who successfully prosecuted the Guildford Four, sending them to prison for 16 years for a crime they didn't commit. I love trivia. Jack joins us fresh from his recent command performance at the Royal Variety Show, where he struck a savage blow against the House of Windsor by ribbing Prince Harry for having ginger hair. Ow, he went there, ladies and gentlemen. Breaking the law, breaking the law. It's Jack Whitehall.
Look, Zig and Zaggy here.
Hello, Zig and Zaggy.
Hey.
Hello, Jack.
Hello.
How's it going?
Very good, thank you.
Hey, Jack. Did you bring him with you?
Did I what, sorry?
Did you bring him with you?
Bring who?
You know.
What?
Bring him with you?
Yeah, yeah, I brought him with me.
Harry.
Harry.
Oh, Harry.
Prince Harry. Oh. Oh.
No idea what's going on there today.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice one, Zig.
Yeah. Nowhere, Zig. Thanks for that. Appreciate it.
Well, hang on a second.
What?
Hang on a second. Can you still do your impression of his dad, Prince Charles?
Oh, can I?
Yeah.
No.
Okay, great. That went even better.
Now, you see this, Mr. Whitehall? You see this? Right? Don't touch it yet.
No.
We're building up.
Yeah.
We had to make a cocktail with you in mind. Mm. So we first came up with the
Whitehall Russian.
Yeah.
Lovely.
But this here is the strawberry Jackery.
Nice.
Happy Christmas, Jack Whitehall.
They pulled it back.
They have. Thank heaven.
Saved it.
A little bit of that.
Check it out.
What are you thinking?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah?
Put it down
because you snowballs for questions.
Okay, so
here
we go.
Here we go.
Check it. Are you saving for the kids?
Back.
I wasn't watching. How many did you get?
Five!
Five out of three. I mean, that is good shooting, isn't it?
Five out of three.
Okay, you get a full interview. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, Bad Education, the movie, massive hit. Bigger than Bond, bigger than Spectre.
Bigger than Spectre, bigger than Bond, bigger than Star Wars altogether. It did really great.
Okay, we have the DVD out on Monday. Okay, we're going to join you in a bar in Cornwall, proving your Cornishity.
Yeah, me trying to be Cornish.
Yes.
This is me trying to be Cornish.
Okay, interesting. Let's have a look at that now.
I don't believe I've had the pleasure. It's an out-of-towner, is it?
Well, this lad's got Cornish blood running through every vein. Meet my son. Conceived in a moment of passion in a faraway port.
I'm just having a few ales here with me old pa.
That port being Kingston, Jamaica.
Me gotta love the dirty wine, but me also love a little bit of fudge.
You love it. Basically, every accent I try to do ends up sounding like Lady Colin Campbell. Posh Jamaican, that's all I can do.
Now, you obviously love the movies. Is it true you two are leaving our shores, our blighty shores, and going to America with your friend James Corden?
No. I did go out to America. I went out, my agent said that I should go out there and do a gig to launch me to the industry. She said, well, book a comedy club, you go there, you do it, and the industry will all be there. I was like, okay, I flew over. Booked this gig, got all my best material together, and then when I arrived, the only error of judgment she'd made, she booked it on Yom Kippur.
Oh dear.
So I don't know whether you know anything about the industry out there, Yom Kippur, where Jewish people aren't allowed out of the house.
Not much goes on, really.
Not much goes on. I went out to launch myself to the industry. There was like four people from presumably Mel Gibson's production company, then no one else. So it didn't go well. The first putting the
well, that didn't go well. Is it true you've been in a movie with Julia Roberts?
Yeah, I did.
Tell us about that, please.
I filmed it last year and it's coming out next year.
That's boring. Tell us stuff that we want to know.
She plays my mother-in-law.
Right.
And she's I don't have any dirt on her. She was really.
I don't want dirt.
No, but that sounded like.
No, just
it was
a bit
leading.
Of colour. Just a bit of colour.
Bit of colour.
Yeah, yeah.
I was in a film with a dwarf on a mobility scooter. Who
no, no, about back to Julia Roberts.
No, in the film, with Julia Roberts, and I was doing a scene like this, and there was a dwarf on a mobility scooter, and he fell asleep in the back of a shot and slid off the mobility scooter, and I had to keep it together because I was acting with Julia Roberts, and all I could see was this amazing comedy show going on behind her.
And that wasn't in the script, presumably.
That wasn't in the script. He was one of the actors, but he was just he'd fallen asleep on his mobility scooter.
So did you befriend Julia Roberts?
That's how good my acting is. It can send people to sleep.
Did you befriend her?
No, not really.
Did you exchange numbers? Did you go around to her house?
No, I didn't. I mean, I tried to become friends with her, but...
How did you try?
I just told her, like, pretty woman.
Did you?
She didn't go down well. It really didn't go down well.
But are you, is that... Will you be... Because you want to act now, that's it. That's what you want to do, isn't it?
Yeah, I enjoy it. Yeah, yeah. I mean, but I'm not desperate to go over there and yeah, I'm really desperate. If it happens, it happens.
Okay, we've got to ask you about what happened last week at the Royal Variety. You are the youngest ever host of the Royal Variety, so well done. Were you nervous about that?
Yeah, it was.
Were you?
Yeah, I was very scared about.
And especially this routine with Prince Harry that you.
Sorry.
No, he's what? Making,
well, no, because you're like the Ginger Mandela.
No, I'm not anymore.
No, I know, but...
I'm a pretend ginger,
yeah. But, you know, I know he was great. He was really, like...
Did you clear that with him first? Yeah, is he a friend of yours?
No.
Do you have his phone number? Do you have his phone number?
No.
You're so deep! Phone him up now.
No, I know.
Because you phoned you up, so you must have it. No? OK. Would you like a Christmas present?
Good.
I think so.
Good,
let's give Jack a Christmas present. Come on, Noah. Come on, Noah. Help us up with this. OK, they say proper Christmas present. OK, from TFI Friday. Thank you so much for coming
Thank
on.
Thank you. Is it Lee Max DVD?
Yeah, it's all the spare ones. No, it's not.
Yeah.
OK, yeah, rip it open. Off you go.
Open.
So this is a toboggan.
Oh! Toboggan. Okay. Oh, and I love that.
It's not really the weather.
John Lewis, wrapping paper.
It's not really the weather for tobogganing. But of course, this is TV.
TV.
So, of course, we have a snow slope that we can bring in. Would you like to visit our snowling alley?
I want to do it.
Let's go snowling, everybody.
Thank you, Noah.
There you go. Right. Now, this is brilliant. This is brilliant, and it does work. You can do this in America.
I don't.
You can have this one. Okay. Okay.
How do I get on? Sit on it.
You just get on. Sit on it. Okay.
Careful.
There you go.
Careful.
Okay. Okay. And now you've got 10 pins down there. Okay. Okay.
Ready?
And now this is a competition.
Yeah.
And the rules are, you've got to put your feet in here.
Yeah.
Okay. And you're
oh
not.
My God.
And you, don't worry. And you must hold your arms up in the air. And you can't flat. This is. You've got to be straight.
Yeah.
You are the bowling ball.
Okay.
Okay. So.
Just push me.
No, not your head.
Just push me.
Not
yet.
Breathe, calm down. No, excuse me, because we're going over to our race commentator, Zig and Zag.
Yes, indeed. Thank you, Christopher, over back in studio. Are you ready, Mr. Whitehall?
Yep.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Hands up in the air as you go. Oh, yes. Very professional. Let's have a look at it again, please. Let's have a look at it. Oh, yes. More like Jumping Jack Whitehall.
Back to you, Christopher, in studio. I know. Right, OK.
Thanks,
we had it reinforced. OK, 7 out of 10, not bad at all.
Not bad.
Alan Partridge, would you like a go? Would you like a go?
Chris, my career's been going downhill for the last 15 years. Last thing I want to do is go on a slouch.
All right, OK, so James Corden, would you like a go, James?
Come on, James!
And you get.
Hang on.
Back to our.
Wait. Why don't I? I might go. I might go.
Whoa! He's go going. Oh! It's never been done before. 7 to me. Over to our race commentator, Zig and Zag.
Yes, indeed. Thank you, Christopher. Over here in the commentary box.
That's right. This is an unorthodox position.
Slightly controversial, Mr. Corden. We're going to count you in.
Clench those buttocks.
50.
No,
49.
Not 50. Not 50. We
48.
Have 50.
What?
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go! Was beautiful, I gotta say.
Absolutely.
Back to you, Chris, in studio.
Disqualified. Disqualified.
I swear
because you kicked the other ones out with your leg, you cheat. See what America does to you.
Oh, sorry, I didn't get the rule, book before I got here.
Well, I read the rules out and you were stuck just there, James Corden. Disqualified.
That was an absolute ridiculous strike. No, no, no.
Okay, how about we have an Olympic gold medalist?
An outrage!
Yes. What about Sir Chris Hoy, 6 gold medals? Yeah. Now, I can tell you, happy Christmas!
Thank you, happy Christmas.
6 gold medals, but this is the most important medal he's ever played for.
You lie down, big man, I'll hold you like a bowling ball.
It's up to you, which way do you want to go?
Okay. Go on. 2 in the stink and down he goes. Right. Ready?
I don't know what that means. And I'm glad to not know what it means. Is it rude? Don't go here again now, please. Okay, disqualified. Oh,
Disqualified.
Okay, 7 legal pins to beat. Over to our race commentator, Zig and Zag.
Yes, indeed, Sir Chris Hoy, are you ready?
I am, yes.
3, 2, 1, go! Stuff there really was. Yeah.
Back to you, Chris.
Back to you in studio.
Thank you very much. It's a perfect 10 without cheating. All right. Okay. Well, this is going well, isn't it? Yeah. No. It's last stunning, Ali. Now, over to Alan. Over to you.
Thanks once again, Chris. Well, now from her new album, X's and O's, from her new album, Love Stuff, King L. It's L King.
Cursing my name, 'cause I found me.
the final episode of Thank Flip It's Friday.
Alan Partridge is here. Come on in.
I'm here with Chris Evans. He's a guest on my show tonight, not the other way around. And Chris, it's great to be here. I love this guy. I really do. What I really do is this draw here. Look, look at that. It's like a snowman's been fed into a wood chipper. Horrific. Now, Chris, I've got to take my hat off to you because, let's face it, with regard to this show, you really are a one-man defibrillator who's looked at the lifeless corpse of TFI and managed to restart its vital organs long enough to get a serious commission.
That's true.
And now its heart beats stronger than ever.
Thank you. Thank you.
Although there's no sign of brain activity. Now, Chris, what we're all dying to know is, are you looking forward next year to presenting Top Gear?
Well, yes, I am. Because
great.
I think...
Yes will do fine. Now it's time for me.
Yeah. James Corden was saying, taking over a big show like that, right?
Yeah, I know,
the thing about it
the
is...
The thing is, Chris, you don't know when to stop.
I think you do now.
Yeah. OK, now let's talk about my new show that's out on Sky Atlantic.
Yay! Yeah,
Mid-Morning Matter starts on Sky Atlantic. Boo, I know, whatever. And it starts on Sky Atlantic in February. We're all looking forward to it. And, Chris, I believe you've got a clip ready for us here.
Have we?
Yes, you have. Roll VT.
Okay,
online now we have an addict who wishes to remain anonymous, so we've disguised their voice. Hello, caller. What's your story?
I'm addicted to gambling.
The sound guy said it'd be fine.
I'm up to my eyes in debt. My marriage is in bits. I've lost my job selling wool at the market. Sorry, I'm getting quite emotional.
It's all right, mate. Take your time. So, your wife had left you?
My husband.
Of course. Sorry. Yes, of course. Men don't sell wool. Listen, love, I think we're going to have to cut this short. The voice distorter's bending your gender. It's also making you sound like a villain from a faraway galaxy. Could you simply say, soon your planet will be mine?
Soon your planet will be mine.
Yeah, yeah, I think we're going to have to leave it there. OK. Some more music. Should we have some more music?
Oh, please, yes.
Okay, performing now not only a brand new track, but an old Christmas classic as well, with You Belong to Me from his new album Get Up and Run, Run, Rudolph. It's a man who's got the same name as my second cousin's best friend, Bryan Adams.
Oh,
you too. I miss you too. I'll call you back. I was chatting with Sir Tom Jones backstage, and he said to me, what show is this? Because he's never heard of TFI. I said, you've been on it 3 times, but he's still never heard of it. He said, what is it? I said, well, it's Imagine the Love Child of Noel's House Party and a televised version of Steve Wright in the Afternoon. But he hadn't heard of them either. So we just washed each other's hands and left the toilet. So it was a bit odd. Anyway, please welcome the man who makes Elvis sound like he's dead, Tom Jones!
Great to be here.
Okay, Zig and Zag, Tom Jones.
Hey, Tom!
Hello.
How's it going, Sir Tom?
Tom Wonderful. Jones!
Yes.
Whoa!
Wow. How are things, all right?
Yeah. How are you, sir?
I'm fine, thank you.
Now, we've been creating cocktails for each of our celebrity guests this evening, and we have one for you here, a very special one.
It's yes.
Now, we were going to go with the You Can Leave Your Man hat on.
Oh, very good. Oh.
Huh? But instead, we went for Sex Bomb on the Beach!
Yeah! Baby!
Have a taste, Tom.
Sir Thomas.
Okay.
All yours.
Here we go.
See what
Let's have a look.
What's it like?
Get out.
Wait a minute. Wow.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
Put some extra bomb in that one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, Ziggy, you do some impressions. You do, you don't do Prince Charles, we know that.
Obviously.
You do Sean Connery. You do Sean Connery.
Sean Connery, there's more than one submarine down here.
Okay, and
that
you
was
do...
Good, that was good, it was okay, wasn't it?
It's okay. Yeah. And you do Victor Meldrew as well?
I don't believe it, Margaret. Someone's stolen the bloody sofa.
That was good.
That's a good one.
Very good. But you also do Sir Tom Jones.
Oh, yes.
Sex bomb. Sex bomb. I'm a sex bomb.
What's that hand doing sex. Down there?
That's what he does. He goes, sex bomb.
Sex
you, Tom.
Bomb.
Can you do it, Tom? Could you do it? Just show me how to do it.
What? Sex bomb?
Just do
sex bomb.
Sex bomb.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Cool. That's okay. The way it should be done. All right. Oh, no.
Now, Thomas, we wouldn't mind doing a bit of asking questions, like, if you wouldn't mind.
Yeah. Not at all.
Because, like, you've got an autobiography out.
Yes.
Right? And we'd like to ask you 3 questions.
Okay.
Three questions. Okay, Sir Tom Jones, legend of singing stuff. Who is your autobiography over the top and back about?
About me, about Tom Jones.
Correct.
Correct. Yes.
Correct. Who wrote your autobiography?
Me, Tom Jones.
All right, who is Tom Jones?
Me, Tom Jones.
I think that clears everything.
Yay!
Here's your cool new CD, which goes with the book.
Yes.
Yes. That's yes. A
book, CD, CD, book.
That's a younger picture of me there, look.
Yeah, it is.
That's and over to you, Christopher.
Well, no, oh, no not over to me. Not over
down.
To me. Over to Alan. Alan!
Hi, Chris. It's great. We're practicing this early on. It's a lot of fun. I'm going to use this Solder Pro 120. And and something lovely happens. So this little snowman here, if I insert it gently into the back of the snowman, with this flame, it should make a little flame come out of its mouth, like a little tongue, like this. It's quite wonderful, it really is. Ah! 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 Go trans! Welcome back to part, I don't know, it feels like 20. Our next guest used to be a blue coat at Pontins, the place where I met the woman who was to go on to be my first wife before leaving me 16 years later, the witch. It's Lee Mack!
Come here. Back in.
Years in the business.
Lee Mack,
zig and zag.
Oh,
Lee! Lee!
It's like all my dreams have come true on the same day.
Cool.
Really? No.
No, didn't think so.
We love you, though, Lee.
I love you. You gave me my first TV interview ever.
Did we?
And you don't remember. Thanks very much.
Yeah.
Mid-90s.
Really?
Yeah, honestly.
Seriously?
And you said we'll stay in touch and I never heard from you again.
No, that is true. I do remember that bit.
Yeah.
Now, Lee, we have made you a special cocktail here. Now, we've been making them all evening. Now, this one here, we were going to go for, a Long Island iced Lee.
Very good, very good.
See? But instead, we went for the Mac and Cheese.
Sounds lovely. Yeah.
Now, just warning you, Lee, there is actual cheese in that cocktail.
Lovely. If you're lactose intolerant or anything, I wouldn't touch it. But
yeah.
Do you want me to drink that?
Yeah, definitely.
I'll tell you what, I'll drink it if you pass it to me.
Properly.
That's about it.
Oh, very clever.
It's quite cheesy.
Okay. Yeah, that's
it's got a subtle sort of dairy leanness about it.
All right, so here we go. I've got some questions for you now, Lee. So first question is, are you still feeling a bit Christmas grouchy? A little bit?
I'm a little bit grouchy. It's your fault, actually, because I came on your Radio 2 show yesterday and got ill.
Well, let's look at this.
A bit better already.
Okay.
And don't forget, kids, a dog is just for Christmas.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
I'm not sure it's not for Christmas. It's not.
See, how are you feeling now, eh?
I feel like really loved up and happy.
Right. Have you got your tree up yet? Because the last time we talked to you, and it was only 2 days ago.
No, I haven't got my tree up yet because you made me ill on your radio show because you sat me next to the lead singer of The Darkness who was heavily ill and gave it to me.
So you're still a bit grouchy.
I am a bit grouchy. You're the dog. I feel better.
Is that better?
I feel better.
Okay, it's a two-dog less grouchy. Okay, best Christmas present you've ever given or received?
I can tell you now, hand on heart, I'll tell you the worst Christmas present, and this is
wasn't the question.
Story. Well, I'm going
to back to the grouch.
Because it's taken me 17 years to tell you this.
Come on.
But my first TV show was on Channel 4 17 years ago, and they said, would you like to come to the TFI bar and meet Chris? And I said to my girlfriend, we're dressing up, we're going to meet Chris. I'm so excited. And we got here, and we couldn't get in.
Still a bit grouchy, isn't it?
Okay. 17 years I've wanted to tell you
okay.
that. They wouldn't let me in.
Okay, what do you want to do? Do you want to talk about your TV show?
17 years, Chris.
Come on, look at this.
Okay. But I forgive you.
Yeah, yes, thank you. Do you want to talk about your TV show or your new DVD? Ooh, dilemma.
Well, this is the struggle now, isn't it? Do I promote that, the Lee Mack Box Set Live Collection?
Yep.
Or not going out on Christmas Eve at 10:45?
Yeah, BBC One.
Let's do neither of them and talk about the dogs.
No, let's watch a clip from your Christmas Eve show. Here we go, not going out.
Hello!
Oh, don't do that. I'm not meant to be here after closing. I could lose my job.
Lose your job? I'm sorry to break it to you, Dad, but there's limited opportunities for elves in January.
We need to find these guards now. Bring the bag.
I'm not her husband. I'm her caddy.
You please stay. I'll just check the first floor.
You know who I blame for this, don't you?
Me.
Why?
Saves you doing it.
Yeah,
I didn't even see that. Was it good?
Okay, the Ice Queen is going to come and take on
our
champion. Ice Queen.
Oh, Ice Queen. Sorry.
Okay, you've got 10 to beat.
There's only 10 there.
No, you are right. There's only 10 there. We have a spare one. Okay, you have a chance of getting 11.
There you go. Okay.
All right, there you go. Do you have a technique, Lee?
I do have a technique. Well, yeah. I've watched the others. What I'm going to do, and this is what's going to happen, I'm going to get to the bottom, I'm going to do the equivalent of a handbrake turn with my bottom, spin it, and it's sideways up. That's not cheating. It's within the rules.
No, thank you.
He's qualified. So
you're right,
Lee. No, he put his legs out. I'm not putting my legs out.
Head judge, by the way, my mum here.
How are you? How are you? Can I just say, by the way, your kids are the cutest kids in the world, and well done, lads, on getting your mum's looks. Okay. Mom,
I'm speaking on behalf
charge,
of the nation.
Okay, over to our race commentators. We have Zig and Zag again with us.
Yep, thanks.
Yes, there's a slight delay, Chris, but we got you.
Hello? Yes, Chris.
All right, okay.
Chris?
Let's do a countdown. Are you ready, Mr.
Keep
Lee
Mack? I'm terrified. You've got to keep
I'm
your arms
up. Three.
I'm
keep
a
belated. Two.
Ten to be.
One.
No!
Arms up.
Arms up at the end. Let's have a look at it again. He didn't put his arms up at the end.
That's
a bit of a knee wobble. A bit of a knee wobble.
Happy Christmas,
happy
Christmas.
Happy
Christmas,
Mars.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it? Right. Whoa, happy
Woo!
Christmas, then.
That's
fun. Live on Channel 4, here we go. Let's meet the Ice Queen.
Ice Queen!
Whoa! To beat 10.
Okay, I'm ready.
A piece of Chris.
Come on, Gabby, you can do it.
Come on. No, not you. Not you, Corden.
Can two of us do it together?
Yes, if you want. Hey, me and you.
Yeah.
No, I can't. I've got to run the show.
Oh, come on.
Okay, you can. No, you can take my little boy with you.
Oh,
both of them.
Okay. Yes. Come
okay.
On.
By the way, come on. Come on, Noah. Bless you. Right. 10
come
to
on,
beat.
Noah.
Right. 10 to beat. Okay.
And
Eli, do you want to go?
Come on, Gabby.
Go on.
Come on.
Go on. Come on. Go on, Eli. Keep running really tight. Over to our. This is a terrible idea.
Very bad.
Over to
Chris.
I'm holding on to them.
I really loved my family. Okay, over to our race commentators.
We're here.
We're right here.
Right here. Chris.
Get out of the way, Evans.
You're breaking up a bit, Chris. You're breaking up.
Okay.
Us.
Are you ready? I can't believe it's Gabby.
I know, Gabby.
Three, two, one.
Go. It's here. She
yes!
wins the medal. She wins the
winner.
Come on, guys. Off you go.
Okay. Join us on New Year's Eve for a very special TFI Friday, where we'll have music and chat from Quentin Tarantino.
Quentin Tarantino.
Kurt Russell.
Wow.
Will Poulter, Neil Fielding, A.D. McCoy, Ollie Murray, Izzy Bizu, New Order featuring LaRue, whoa. Sia, and Florence and the Machine.
So fingers crossed, it's Leander Hummus and Sir Tom Jones.
Later on, we'll conspire as we dream.
face I'm afraid. The plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland.
You're in town.
Christmas Day, even. In fact, especially Christmas Day. I mean, I've been asking some chat. I'll leave it there.